the Fundy Fringe Festival, uncensored, unjuried, and unbelievably entertaining. F4 Fringe Power is radio in support of the Fundy Fringe Festival on local 107.3 FM. The 2021 Fundy Fringe Festival is over. Welcome to the Epilogue Show. I'm Tim Trunnell.
I'm Stephen Coyle.
Welcome to a very,
very special,
yeah, special episode. Welcome to a very special episode of
Fringe Power.
Fringe Power. I didn't know you were gonna read my mind there and know what I was gonna say for the rest. I thought you were just gonna say, "Hey, I'm Steve," but you're like reading my mind.
That's scary.
That's pretty good though.
Oh yeah.
You know what? I used to have theater classes where they try to make us do stuff like that.
Oh, okay.
Try to anticipate,
right,
and say the same things,
mm-hmm,
as your partner in the lesson is doing. So you kind of had to mimic at the same time. Oh, it was strenuous.
I betcha.
Quite stressful with the teachers, but yeah, you did that quite well. Fringe Power is radio in support of the St. John Fundy Fringe Theater Festival, and you're listening to F4. This is the wrap-up. This is where we basically come together after the Fringe Festival, the 2021 Fringe Festival that has succeeded in putting on another great year after such a difficult time with the COVID and everything like that. 2020 was amazing. We still managed to have a theater festival during pretty much lockdown. And this year, we're bouncing back. As some of you may know, I tried to exercise my entrepreneurial skills to sell all things Fringe to the Disney Corporation. I really thought it was a good deal. I thought it would benefit everybody. However, it didn't work. And in doing so, I realized I just need a little bit more variety in the show. I had a great idea. My friend Steve, I want to introduce you all to my good friend Steve. He's our guest co-host for our final episode of the 2021 Fringe Power Year. How you doing, Steve?
Good, Tim. I'm glad to be here.
Great. Well,
it's something I've never done before.
You've never done this?
No.
Are you serious?
No.
I could have sworn that you had done something familiar to this before. Steve and I have worked on a number of promotional campaigns for the city for a couple of years now, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
And in that time that we've spent together, you've mentioned that you kind of grew up around radio.
Yes, I have.
Yeah, was it your father, right?
No, I actually listened to the radio quite a lot, and I've learned quite a lot from the disc jockeys that I listened to in the mornings and afternoon drives and so on.
But you like radio.
Yes.
Yeah, and I remember you telling me stories about you and your father used to take trips to.
Yes, to the radio, went to the radio station in St. John.
Yeah, and you like that?
Yes.
That's pretty cool.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I remember my first tour of a radio station too when I was a kid.
It's fun, isn't it?
I know. It was really good. So when I thought of, kind of spicing up the show and giving a little bit of variety, I thought, why not bring Steve on in and he can co-host with me? What was your favorite DJ back in the day? Who was your favorite DJ back in the day, I mean?
My favorite DJ back in the day was Jim Levine that works for Country 94 in St. John, New Brunswick.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So you're big, you listen to country music?
Yes,
a lot?
Most of the time, yeah.
Big fan of country music?
Oh, yeah.
Nice. So that encouraged you to kind of want to pursue some more radio?
Yeah, it just kind of piqued my interest. I used to, when I was a kid, I used to make on, I was a disc jockey in my room. I'd plug in my ghetto blaster and play different songs on the radio and pretend I was a disc jockey.
Yeah.
Yeah.
that's pretty cool. I can see that happening. Those radio stations aren't around anymore, are they?
No.
A lot of the older ones that we grew up with.
No.
They're not around. I think my favorite, I don't remember one from the towns that I was in, but do you remember like Wolfgang Jack?
Yes.
Or Wolfman Jack?
Yes.
So Wolfgang.
Yes.
Wolfman Jack.
Yeah.
And Casey Kasem.
Mm-hmm.
There used to be a guy named Dr. Demento.
I don't remember him.
He used to play silly songs late at night. Like, I used to hide under my blanket at night. No, but I was supposed to be sleeping as a kid, but I had this little radio that managed to, I don't know, only at nighttime, it used to get a radio station all the way down in Seattle.
Wow.
And yeah, and this was like in southern British Columbia. And this guy, Dr. Demento, he'd play all the songs that, you know, you liked hearing as a kid, like
yes,
Fish Heads.
Oh, yeah.
You remember The Streak?
Yes.
Or
by Ray Stevens.
Yeah, here we go. You know, yeah, all that stuff. Yeah. And, you know, I just love that. I love that. So, yeah, so Steve and I, you know, we've spent a lot of time, John, about things, and I thought it'd be really nice to kind of bring a fresh perspective to the show. Fringe Power has been a show that's been dedicated to interviewing people that are involved with a Fundy Fringe Theater Festival that's been happening as well for 9 years.
Oh, so, yes, I remember that.
Yeah, so we have local people and we have visiting performers from all over the world, really, that come in. And, you know, we give a listen to the shows that they have and what's to be offered to the audiences of St. John. And it's really great. It's $10.
Okay.
For a show. Right. All shows, right? Okay. You go to a show, it's $10.
Right.
You go in, you see a show, lasts about an hour.
Mm-hmm.
Any kind of show, usually. There's something for every taste, right? And all the money from that ticket sale goes straight to the artist. Like, there's no commission being taken.
Yeah. Yes.
It's really neat. And you get a chance to see some really wonderful theater pieces that you don't usually see. It brings theater experiences to people that might not be able to. And I was thinking, well, Steve, this is a theater radio show, but
yes,
have you seen any theater plays yourself?
Not really, but I've seen them on TV.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
Was there anything that stuck out in your mind in particular?
Not really, but I just, you know, just kind of glanced at them. But when I've seen them, they're neat. They're neat.
Yeah, and like me, we watch a bit of TV.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, because you and I kind of bond a bit.
Yes.
About older television shows that we grew up with, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Hey, thanks for being on the show.
No,
I really appreciate
you
being here. I know you probably gave up watching a NASCAR race or something today, didn't you?
No, that's on later this afternoon.
Oh, you're still going to catch it?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, perfect.
Yeah.
Who are you rooting for?
It all depends on who's going to win.
Well, of course, we always root for the guy who wins.
Exactly.
Oh, that guy won? Yeah, I was rooting for him for the longest time. We could, we could go to a song.
Okay.
What do you think? We'll go to a song.
Okay.
So what's your favorite song?
Let's go with Bob Seger and Old Time Rock and Roll.
Bob Seger, Old Time Rock and Roll? Okay, do you want to introduce it and click the button?
Okay. On the right side?
Yep.
This is Bob Seger and Old Time Rock and Roll.
Last summer camp was good for me. We did so many new things, like horseback ride. Then went to the pool for a swim. They were at water sports. I was in a canoe with my friends. Going the woods, then played laser tag. On the day came, they did some paintball in this battlefield. After all that orchard, I know to shoot a bow and arrow, that it's archery. I always loved to do. We came back to our cabins. We've lived at devotions. Everyone has ran for cover from the rainstorm. We had it. When I left, was the best time of my life.
Okay, so that was, so what we just heard, that wasn't Bob Seger's Old Time Rock and Roll.
Okay.
Because there's kind of a rule here at Local 107.3 FM that we don't play pop music or top 40 stuff. It's all local music. independent music in St. John, in Canada, anywhere in the world, you know, something like that. So what we listened to was someone else. Do you know who it was?
No.
That was Jordan Alexander.
Okay.
We know Jordan.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, we know Jordan. That's one of his songs.
Yeah.
You click the button again. Okay, I'm just teasing you. That was Jordan Alexander, straight out of St. John, and his song, Coming Together, from Radical T Productions. Jordan Alexander's music can be found on YouTube and Spotify, and we will post links on our Fringe Power Facebook later. Makes no difference who you are. When you wish upon my star, dreams come true. Now, weather with Stephen. Okay. What's the weather like out there, Steve?
It is sunny and warm today, and it's 22 degrees in St. John, New Brunswick. It is going to be low precipitation tonight.
How low?
20%.
Nice.
It's going to be hot and sunny tomorrow in the city of St. John with a high of 23 degrees.
That was Weather with Steve on Fringe Power, local 107.3 FM. Thanks a lot, Steve.
Not a problem, Tim.
So before we get into the nitty-gritty, if I can say nitty-gritty, we're old enough, we can say nitty-gritty.
Oh, yeah.
Really get into this show and have some candied fennel.
Okay.
Just to get us in the mood. Have you ever had candied fennel before?
No.
Okay. It's a little tiny candy.
Okay.
You want some?
Sure.
Okay, here. I'm coming over.
Okay.
Putting down the headset. I'm coming over. Here we go. I'll just give you a few. They're like little tiny things.
Okay.
Okay. Little tiny things. They're candy.
Okay.
But they got a little tiny plant in them.
Okay.
Wow. Kind of tastes like licorice.
Okay.
...2021 marks the first Fundy Fringe without Festival Director Sarah Rankin, as she has moved on to other things. We missed talking with her this year, as we usually do talk with her every year. And this season of Fringe Power has been such a sausage party without her. So, here are some highlights of Sarah on our show since 2014. Our current executive director of the Fundy Fringe Festival, who has joined us here in the blanket tent, welcome to the show, Sarah Rankin. How are you?
I'm great, Tim. How are you?
Good, good, good. And I appreciate you coming in fully prepared. I like the pajamas.
Thank you. I brought out my special Snuggie just for you.
Is that a Christmas present?
Yeah, it was, actually. I got it from my mom.
For your mom or from your mom?
For my mom, and I got one from my mom. It was a really awkward Christmas.
Oh. Sorry to have Matt Damon'd you last weekend and run out of time, but, like, you know, setting up the drum kit was a little bit more... more endeavorous than we expected.
No worries. I'm totally glad to give the time to the performers rather than myself. Everything is going super amazing at the office right now. We're well ahead on a lot of the stuff that we wanted to get ready. We're going to start seeing some posters around soon.
Good.
So that's really cool. And we've got a bunch of special events all prepared and everything. So we're going to have quite the party this year.
You know what time it is?
What time is it, Tim?
Time to hit the sack.
Oh, God.
I like what you've worn. You knew we were going to have a sleeping bag this time, so you wore your camping gear.
You've got
18 layers on or something like that.
I get really cold. It's cold out, man.
Oh, I know.
So
you look like a big Care Bear.
I have like 13 hoodies on right now.
Okay, I think we can make it in here. Okay.
All right.
And hopefully the husband... Well, you've got 13 hoodies. The husband shouldn't mind. Okay.
No, he won't care.
Okay. There we go. Okay. And then...
Oh, God.
Oh, my God!
You couldn't invest in the double. You had to bring the single.
Oh, my gosh. Your toes are so cold. They're like ice cubes.
I know. I told you. It's cold out.
You should check a doctor out about that. Circulation.
Probably.
Circulation. You had a volunteer meeting not too long ago.
Yes.
Oh, this arm. One sec. Let's get this arm again. Okay. How did that go?
Really well. The turnout has been fabulous. We're still definitely looking for more volunteers because the festival is just going to be that much bigger this year. We need more hands on deck. So we're actually having a big old volunteer party.
Oh, good, good, good. Like
on
parties.
Wednesday. So it's going to be amazing. JQ and Andrea and myself and Kelsey, we're all going to be there. We're going to have craft time.
Good.
We're going to bring crafts the paints out, get some signage ready, perfect. Get some promotional stuffs ready so that people will know where to go and how to buy buttons and all that cool stuff.
So you're finding your new job as director of the festival pretty good.
It's fun.
It's going very well?
It's very fun.
Good. And so people, please remember to contact the Fundy Fringe Festival offices about volunteer opportunities for yourself as soon as you can. And what is that contact number again, or is it an email or both?
Actually, probably the easiest way would be just to go straight to our website, www.fundyfringefestival.com/volunteers. And if you scroll down to the bottom, there is a link there to fill out the form and sign up to become a volunteer. All the information's there. Everything is all tickety-boo.
Having a Fringe Festival in St. John is a big deal.
It's pretty huge, and I sometimes wonder if people understand how huge it is that we have a Fringe Festival here.
Can you enlighten people about that then a little bit on why it's important to have, why it's such a monumental festival to finally have in St. John?
Well, we're a part of history now. This whole Fringe mentality and style started years and years and years and years and years ago over in Scotland, and it's been in Canada for quite some time. And now that we are a part of this, we're actually part of like quite a huge family of Fringe festivals that are all over the country, and it's bringing artists, international artists, national artists into our city that we had never heard of before. I think it's all about just taking a risk. Like, instead of assuming that it's our job to educate about theater and assuming that it's, you know, our role as the practitioners or somehow these great gurus of theater, that somehow it's our responsibility to go out there and educate. I think the neat thing about Fringe is that we're not coming at people and saying we're the experts. We're coming at them and saying we're trying something new, we're trying something different. Why don't you join us and see if you can create something with that too? Mm-hmm. There's a risk involved. And I think that's what we're having a hard time sort of getting, is people to take that risk and to try something new.
And it's inexpensive. It's a very inexpensive risk.
And that's like, yeah. So we're creating an environment that is, you know, taking a risk, but you're not threatened by it, I guess you could say. There's not a big threat when it comes to Fringe. Yeah, we're not censored. We're not juried. It's affordable.
Sarah.
Hi, Tim.
Have you had any sleep at all this week?
What sleep?
Oh.
I'm just really happy to be in this bed right now. I'll just put it that way.
So comfy.
So
the
comfy.
Show is finished. We can silently all walk out, close the door, and let you have a few five minutes.
Thank you. I would really appreciate that.
What's the biggest surprise about this year's Fundy Fringe Festival for you that you didn't expect?
I think right now, the turnout and support at our special events. Those were something completely brand new for us. I didn't even know if that would work out. I didn't know if anybody in St. John would respond to it. Lo and behold, at the open mic night last night and at the big tease the night before that, we had a huge turnout of people, and I was really, really impressed with not only, you know, the artists that came out and showed their stuff off at the big tees, but some of the people that came up and did things at the open mic that I'm like, wow, St. John's got a ton more talent than just what is on the stage that we see all the time.
Big studio all here to myself. No longer. I have our first guest with us here on the second series of In Bed with Tim Trinnell and the third season of F4 Fringe Power, Festival Director of the Fundy Fringe Festival, Sarah Rankin. Thank you, Sarah, for joining me in bed again today.
I'm so happy to be back in your bed, too.
Thank you.
Yay.
It's not the greatest. I tried to put it together, but my my arm, well, you know.
It's okay. It's fine.
I didn't want to put it all together. I just thought, I did this last year. Let's not hammer the theme too much. Anyway. But yeah, congratulations on, and thank you for wearing pajamas once again. What
of
is
course.
That?
Well, they are in honor of Fundy Fringe and being St. John's Fringe. I decided to go a little St. John chic tonight. So I am wearing my baggiest, most comfiest cigarette burn hole laden jeggings for you.
I didn't know you smoked.
Well, they're not mine.
Oh, well, okay. So The Fringe throne must be getting pretty comfy for you by now. This is your second year as the festival director, is it not?
It is, well, yeah.
It is, but how is it so far? Is it anything different for you in your experience this year as festival director than compared to last year?
A little bit less stress, because now I feel like I've kind of got my feet under me. I've gotten 1 year under my belt. I know the basics of it now, so my goals this year are simply to keep growing, make it bigger. Now that I'm comfortable, I don't want to stay comfortable. I want to make it as challenging for myself as I can. So adding new things, adding new features to it, bringing more performers in. Yeah, it's going to be a party. It's going to be great. I can't believe that we're kind of getting the, I wouldn't say fame, but maybe the renown that we're getting from across the country with the other Fringe festivals. They're interested in what we're doing, and we've got a nice solid base under us, and I think it's a good platform to create some new stuff. I usually buy 3 of the passes, and I just wander around with them. And if I see somebody hanging around that says, well, I don't know if I want to go see this show yet, I just bring them along with me.
Smart.
Or if there's an artist I see that's like, well, I was going to go see this show. Because these artists, they're coming to the city, they're paying out of their own pockets to come and stay in St. John, pay their fees for the festival, paying for their food and all that kind of stuff. They really don't have the extra pocket change necessarily to go and see a bunch of shows as well, and they're busy as well, so I like to tag them along with me. I'll grab a few performing groups and say, come on, we're all going to go see this show together.
You're going to hang out, because my next guest is going to be a familiar voice, if not face.
So very good. Yeah, I don't want to leave you all alone here. You seem, well, I'm sorry.
What?
I've been you seem a little,
okay, say it. Judd's not here.
You seem a little lonely, Tim. I'm sorry, okay?
I don't care. It's fine.
Are you...
Don't worry about it. I can do this. I don't need him.
Tim, are you crying? Are you okay?
I need to find a song. But now I am not the only person that has been naked in the Fringe now.
Nope. Scott Lilly was naked in the second year, and then last year we had Teatro Kata from Montreal, and they pretty much got naked every single time, so... It's kind of a little good luck thing for the Fundy Fringe. There's always somebody naked.
Oh, good.
Either somebody gets naked in a show, or somebody just happens to end up naked at some point
at some point during the evening, yeah.
And then the cops get called, and we're all shamed.
But that gets us that grant money. It's
exactly,
art.
Exactly, that's
it's
why
art.
The grant funders love us. Like I said before, I think in the first episode, we try to keep about 50% of them. And this year, it just worked out that we had more local artists finally. So,
okay.
Which is really cool to see that St. John is, you know, on the rise as a cultural community. But I also think it's really important for us to bring in artists from outside of the city, because, you know, we don't often get to do that. We don't often get affordable theater or experimental theater coming through from other places in St. John. So it's a great chance for people to come out and see some new stuff that they won't ever really get a chance to see again necessarily. Unless I decide to go down to Halifax for Atlantic Fringe.
Yeah, save the money, stay here, and get culturally educated.
Da, da, da.
So you're going to be okay while we talk here, Watson?
Yeah, he'll be a good boy.
Good boy. Last sounds of summer.
You can tell how big
his
engine is. Whoa. Whatever they're thinking of creating, bring it to the table, because Fringe is the mode to do it with. It doesn't matter if it's a polished and finalized, refined product, or if it's something you're just trying out. See if it sticks to the wall.
Great. It's going to be welcome. Well, here we are. We'll get Watson in. And once again, Sarah, thank you for everything. Congratulations on another year accomplished. And
we'll see
you next year.
Thank you, Tim, for being our steadfast radio host and steadfast performer and steadfast Fringe fan and supporter.
Well, I'm going to definitely sleep for a week after this. Donovan Jackson, thank you again. And Watson, you were a good dog. Once again, we are very happy to welcome back to the show Sarah Rankin, director of the Fundy Fringe Festival, and Tabraise and Robin, the Modern Mind Readers. I've got some cutlery.
I knew you'd bring spoons.
Did you? Yeah. See? Look. See? Amazing.
Are we playing spoons?
No.
I haven't played spoons since university.
Me
Watch
too.
Out for your knuckles.
Me too. They had a spoon workshop at university when I went there. Now, I don't know. Let me just see. I brought an assortment because I didn't know if...
I'll just give it to me all the...
Sure. There we go.
The salt spoon. You brought these, right? So there's no way that I'm going to...
spoons. Yep. Sarah's checking one and I'm checking one.
Looks like the ones my mom had in her kitchen.
And Sarah, will you please just point to one of these? Okay, perfect. So I'll use this one. Hold on to that one for me. I want you to just do this with me. Put your hand, or put the spoon in your hand there.
Okay.
I'm just going to try to concentrate on it. In your mind, just keep saying bend over and over again. Ready?
Yeah, bend.
In your mind. Just in your mind.
Is this wrong?
Crazy. Oh my
God. See that bending?
Wait. God, it's bending.
It's just lying there.
Hell.
It's just lying there. And
I'm going to keep my language very PG here.
Wait, well, there it is. It's lifting. I'm literally seeing
it's
a spoon.
It's the Matrix scene. The spendy spoon. Like, we have to realize this, there is no spoon.
That's absolutely bent.
That's awesome.
Let's try that a little more.
Okay, so we're in the same positions as before. Sarah's got a new item in her hand. Tabraise is in front of her. Blocking the view of Robin. Robin's eyes are closed, and I'm making sure Robin's eyes are closed. Okay.
Go along, just call out the object.
Okay.
Concentrate.
Just focus on what this next object is.
But don't.
Okay, just concentrate on your mind, Sarah. Just scream it in your mind. Tabraise, I want you to concentrate on this object as well.
Go along, just let me know what it is, darling.
I'm seeing something kind of sharp. There's a point to this. Is this a pin?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's right. Quickly tell us what the pin's for.
Is this for the Fundy Fringe Festival pin?
Yes!
Oh my gosh. That's pretty wild. Half of me is like, more than half of me is enjoying this, but you know, there's always that, you know, that inch of a skeptic, right? Right,
Sarah? And that's me as a person. I'm always kind of curious as to how all this works and stuff like that. And I'm a very, you know, scientific person. I mean, I work in the arts, but I love science and I love kind of how the brain works. And so when this kind of stuff happens, I'm always like, all right, let's see if we can kind of push the limits of it. So that's why I went for something that was a little bit outside of the box, a little bit. Just wanted to, like... Oh, and dude.
I know, that's amazing, because I'm here, and there's no physical contact between Robin and Tabraise, right?
As you know, I told you last time, we offer $10,000 to anyone that can offer, or anyone that can prove that we use any sort of electronic devices, secret assistants, or actors in the audience.
It's been interesting. It's a bit of chasing and herding cats, but everybody seems ready to go.
Yeah, speaking of cats, what's that cat's name again that you have in the hub here? Mrs.
Yes.
Great. So it's one of the students' cats?
Yes. One of our volunteer coordinator, Kennedy, brought her cat in today.
I'm a big fan of cats. Yeah. Well, we appreciate you, Sarah. Thank you very much for all your hard work, you and the team, and everything that you've done to help accommodate the festival to continue during these unprecedented times.
Dun,
dun, dun. Great, and good luck. I hope you get an awesome staycation after this.
I hope so, too. Great. We'll see.
That was former director Sarah Rankin through the Fringe Power Ages. Thank you again, Sarah, for your time, your work, and you. I'll save you a bag of candied fennel for you. We already miss you, Watson. You were a good dog.
This is Steve on Fringe Power with my co-host, Tim.
Time for our Fringe Power movie review on Local 107.3 FM. Here's Movies with Steve. What's your favorite movie, Steve?
Grease.
Right. And, okay, what's your review?
Which came out in 1978.
Was it really?
Yes.
Okay. What's your movie review? Thumbs up or thumbs down?
Thumbs up.
Both thumbs?
Yes.
What's your favorite? Oh, there they are.
Yeah.
What's your favorite part about? Give us an idea of what the movie is about for listeners who might not know Grease.
A lot of it was had different actors in it, from Olivia Newton-John and John Travolta, and it was based on the beach and stuff, and they were in high school at the time, and different things.
A lot of music.
Yes.
Like
Summer Nights and You're the One That I Want. And
the Bee Gees had a song in there, right?
Yeah. Yes.
That's a play.
Yes.
So in a sense, you have seen a play.
Yes.
But a television version of it.
Yes.
All right. So you recommend people go see Grease?
Yes.
Either the movie or the play?
Yes.
Well, wonderful. We appreciate your review.
Thank you very much.
You're always right on the money when it comes to your movie reviews. Thanks a lot.
Thank you very much, Tim.
That was Steve's and Movie Reviews with Steve.
We'll be back right after this commercial break.
Awesome.
St. John's Alternative Radio, local 107.3 FM.
This is Sarah Rankin, your
antecedent
Fundy Fringe Festival director, and you're listening to local 107.3.
Welcome back to Fringe Power on 107.3.
Here is your sports report with Stephen Coyle.
What's your sister going to see again? What's that show? Or no, what's that game show?
Oh, it was a ball game in Moncton that my nephew was going to.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Have you watched him in baseball before?
At Chris Pam's sis' ball field.
Okay.
Yeah.
Was it softball or baseball?
Baseball.
Okay. Do you like baseball?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, I just don't watch a lot of it.
Okay. Who's your favorite team when you do watch?
Yeah, I really don't have a favorite team.
Yeah, not your thing? More hockey?
Yeah, more hockey
all the way.
Yeah.
Yeah. Any other sports that you like?
Yeah, I like tennis and stuff like that.
Serious? Tennis?
Oh, yeah.
Hockey to tennis?
Oh, yeah.
Back to you, Tim.
Sports. And nothing but
sports with Steve.
Earlier, we heard a song from local St. John singer-songwriter Jordan Alexander. We speak to him by phone about what inspires him. On the phone right now, we have the musician Jordan Alexander, whose work you have been hearing on today's episode. Jordan, how are you doing today?
I'm doing pretty good. How about you?
Good, good. Thanks for joining us, and thank you for the music.
You're welcome.
Now, how many albums do you have out right now?
I have 3 albums out already.
3. That's pretty good. And how old are you, Jordan?
I am 27.
27? Well, congratulations. How long have you been doing music in your life?
I started around 6.
6 years old?
Yeah, 6 years old.
Uh-huh. And you've been doing it ever since. So you got about, you got about 21 years on you there, huh? When did you...
Yeah, 21 years, yes.
When did you release your first album?
My first album was Camp Rotary.
Camp Rotary? Yeah.
It was done last year, 2020.
And your other album?
Which is the Christmas album.
Christmas album, yeah.
That was out last year, 2020.
And then, of course, we've got this new one, the Beautiful Morning Sunrise.
Yeah, that was out last year.
Yeah. No, that's really good. And people can not only hear your music on Spotify, but we can also see what you're doing every once in a while. We can check in on you with the YouTube channel, right?
Yes.
What inspires you to write? Like, what are your biggest influences for your music?
When it comes to me, I just write down a piece of paper and just jump to it.
Because I've seen you. You walk around, you got like a big notebook on you all the time. You're always writing in it.
Yes, I'm always writing new songs, like for the next album.
Mm-hmm.
And it's going to be really good.
Yeah, because most people you see your age are running around with a phone stuck to the front of their face. But you're always writing. You've got a great work ethic there. And geez, I wish I wrote as much as you did.
Yes.
Hey, have you ever tried candied fennel before?
What'd you say?
Have you ever tried candied fennel?
Candied fennel?
Fennel, yeah.
I've never tried it before.
Yeah, it's like candy with a little tiny piece of plant in there. It kind of freshens your breath after a tasty meal. I don't know, just curious. Just curious. Hey, who's your favorite entertainer?
My favorite entertainer is Michael Jackson.
Michael Jackson?
Justin Bieber.
Okay, Bieber, yeah, good choice.
And Bruno Mars.
Bruno Mars, okay.
And Luke Bryan.
Luke Bryan. Now, he's kind of like a country singer, right?
Yes.
Okay, but you don't really do country music, per se, do you?
But sometimes I do a little mix-up of country.
Yeah? So what do you think... What do you call your music genre then? Is it pop? Is it rock? Country? Folk? Like what?
It's more like pop music.
Pop music, eh? Okay, yeah, because it's definitely unique. That's for sure. It kind of reminds me of Leonard Cohen, you know, talking over a song. Sometimes it's you've definitely got a lot of thought and work going in the lyrics. That's for sure.
Yeah, and. All the lyrics are real.
They come from the heart.
Yes.
Yeah. Now, I've seen some of your YouTube videos, and they're quite good. You're always starting with a nice video shot of the roof, I think it is, with all the laser lights going around.
Yes, that's kind of cool.
Yeah, that is really cool. I do like that. And then you bring the camera down to you. In your studio, you have a gigantic studio. You like have a legit studio in your house.
Yes.
Is that your room or is that just a?
I have two rooms.
You have two rooms, two studio rooms.
I have one like in my bedroom. I have a setup.
Okay.
It's just like for the rehearsals.
Okay.
And then I have. A recording studio in at my house.
Yeah, that's what I can see in the background of the videos. It's yeah. Pretty impressive. So you rehearse in your bedroom, and then you walk over to your studio room and you record it, right?
Yes.
that's pretty good. So you must have been you must have done really well during the COVID lockdown. You had a lot of you had everything you needed.
Yes, I did. Yeah. Because I'm still writing some new songs.
Oh, you're writing new songs now?
Yes.
So there's a new album coming out, I presume?
Yeah, next year there's going to be a new album coming out. It's called This Love Remains.
This Love Remains. And we'll be able to hear that on Spotify, right?
You'll hear it on Spotify, Apple Music, and on YouTube.
That's really good. Congratulations. There's a lot of hard work you're putting in there, Jordan.
Thank you. I put a lot of effort into this.
Yeah. Now, is there a chance that we're going to see you do a live concert or a tour anytime soon with all this material that you've amassed?
I would like to do like a fall tour out of it, like a world tour.
A world tour? Yeah. Well, hopefully we can get world tours going again after the pandemic kind of, you know, settles down.
Yeah.
So if you're doing a world tour, who in your wildest dreams, right? Who would you want in your wildest dream? Who would you want to open for you?
Radical T Productions.
Well, Radical T Productions is your production company, right?
Yes.
Yeah, but I mean, you know how you usually have another band to play before the big band goes on?
Yes.
So who would you want to open up for you?
I think Justin Bieber.
You want Justin Bieber to open up for you?
Yes.
Great. That'd be like a double Canadian whammy.
Yes.
That's pretty good. What was the first concert you ever saw?
That I ever saw was at Camp Rotary.
No, I mean concert. Did you ever go out and see any concerts when you were younger?
When I was younger, I was seeing Hilary Duff in concert.
You saw Hilary Duff?
Yeah.
Dude, you're dating yourself now.
I used to date her, but she's grown on me.
Yeah. Well, how old were you then?
How old? I was probably around 12 or... Like around 12.
12, eh? Jeez. Was it a good concert?
It was a very big concert.
Yeah. And you liked it?
I loved it.
Great. Who would you want to go see next?
What I see next is probably Justin Bieber.
Yeah. You know what? Lately I've been humming a lot of Justin Bieber myself too. I wasn't intending to, but it just kind of grows on you, and yeah, definitely.
Yes.
So the music and the writing and the producing, I know you've got a lot of people, you got a big team, a crew, a posse, an entourage?
Yes, I do, yes.
So yeah, who helps you out with some of this stuff?
My manager, Tom Radcliffe.
Tom Radcliffe, great. And he helps you get stuff out there online and helps you with the music?
Yes, he helps me with the music, what I'm doing.
Mm-hmm.
And I just go hard.
That's the only way to go, bud. Go hard. So you're going to be, so I assume that as soon as we're finished here, you're going back to write another song, aren't you?
Yeah. Yes, I am, yes.
Good. Good. I'm glad. What other hobbies do you have, Jordan?
Hobbies?
Yeah.
I like exercising.
Exercising?
I like basketball. I like hockey.
Now, do you like watching or do you like actually doing the sport?
I like doing sport.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I don't like doing hockey, but I can watch hockey once in a while. Basketball, yeah, I can watch it and play it, but yeah, definitely. It is.
I played basketball.
Yeah?
For Nationals.
Hey, knowing you, what color socks do you have on right now?
Right now, I got the thicker socks.
There's no avocados on them?
No.
No pineapple shirts?
No, no pineapple shirts.
That's great. That is great. We're definitely going to post that on social media and make sure everyone has an idea of where to go to see your or to listen to your stuff on Spotify and YouTube. We're going to post that for sure.
Yes, thank you so much.
No problem. Hey, Jordan, it's great talking with you, and I really appreciate your time. And you know, and I hope the rest of your summer goes well.
Yeah, hope your summer goes well too.
Thanks a lot, Jordan, and yeah, keep going hard, buddy.
Yep, I'm always going hard.
Great. All right, have a good night.
Yeah, thank you.
Bye.
Bye. Thank you.
You are listening to F4 Fringe Power, and I'm with my co-host, Stephen Coyle. That was Jordan Alexander and Radical T Productions' I'm Growing Up. Check out Jordan's YouTube channel. He's one of a few Jordan Alexanders on that site, so try jordansings02@gmail.com. That's the actual name of the channel when you search for it. You can also find Jordan Alexander on Spotify, where you can hear all three of his albums, including the latest, and other songs, like Is He Fly Fishing?, When I Sit on My Deck Find Upcoming Star, and Jordan's Christmas Song. Now, he's not the Jordan with the hoop earrings. Our Jordan is the purple and gold profile pic of Jordan standing by a river. Now it's news with Stephen Coyle.
Now you can do the news.
I can do the news. You don't want to do the news?
No, not really.
Okay. Last little while, we've had a segment called Stone Pillow, and it's named after Lucille Ball.
Okay. Yeah. Yes.
It's named after Lucille Ball's television movie, Emmy award-winning movie, if I remember correctly.
Yes, I think it was.
Yeah, and she, Lucille Ball.
Yes.
Yeah, it's great. So anyway, I just take theater questions out the street. So, now, Steve, do you want to play?
Yeah, sure.
You want to play Stone Pillow?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, good. Okay, because I've got a special Stone Pillow ready just for you.
Okay.
Because I know, as we talked about, and no judgment, nope. you don't know a lot of theater.
No.
No? Okay. I mean, you and I, we talk more about, I don't know, sports or television shows or music or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
So I've tailored a special Stone Pillow for you.
Okay.
I just gotta find it. Okay. Are you ready?
Oh, I'm ready.
Yeah? Okay, yep. This is gonna be fun. All right. So, and like I said, I know you don't know much about theater.
Okay.
No judgment.
Nope.
This is tailored for you specifically.
Okay.
Okay. So, so just relax and have fun.
Okay.
First question. During the Q2Q of the very first presentation of Waiting for Godot during the week between January 1st and the 5th of 1953, who fell asleep in the Théâtre de Babylone and had a dream that not only changed the outcome of the play, but also made writer Sam Beckett quit smoking for the rest of that month?
Oh, good question.
Bonus question, bonus points for what was the dream about?
No idea.
I pulled a joke on you again.
Next time. I know. Little bugger.
I know, that's me. Hey, remember, you're not supposed to swear.
Oh, yeah.
We'll beep that out, you bugger. Okay, here's one. In our time together, we do a lot of talking about TV, right?
Yes, yes.
And since radio is supposedly the theater of the mind, then TV is theater of its own kind, wouldn't you say?
Yes.
Okay. So so we're still in the theater mode here when I ask you this question.
Okay.
Who was Skipper's little buddy, and with what did he usually hit him over the head with?
His hat. And it was Gilligan's Island.
It was Gilligan's Island. Nice. Yeah. I love that show.
Yeah, me too.
I saw I think I've seen every episode like 2-3 times over as a kid.
Growing up. I know, me too.
But I never saw the pilot episode.
I didn't either.
No, it's black and white.
Yes.
Yeah, I finally saw it.
Did you?
Yeah, it was quite good.
Yeah, I bet you.
Yeah, and I also saw I Dream of Jeannie pilot as well.
I never saw that one.
Never saw that one?
No.
You can see it on YouTube.
No.
Next question. So that's one. You got one. The first one doesn't count because I was just pulling your leg. Okay, so you got 1 point. You're okay. One out of one.
Okay.
Good going.
Okay.
Second question. What was the name of the daughter that Samantha and Darren had on the show Bewitched?
Oh.
Which also there was a spinoff with the daughter grown up.
Okay.
Do you remember Bewitched?
Yes.
Yeah.
Tabitha.
Nice. Nice. Not many people get this. She had a spinoff. Did you ever see the spinoff?
No, I didn't.
Was she grown up? Yeah.
No.
Yeah, Tabitha. It's a thing.
Okay. True. Okay.
In the once longest running primetime cartoon show, The Flintstones.
Yes.
Who voiced the Great Gazoo? Now, this is a multiple choice. Was it A, Tim Conway, B, Sidney Poitier, C, Harvey Korman, or D, Betty White?
Tim Cormier.
Is that your final answer?
It's my final answer.
No.
No?
Is The Great Gazoo was voiced by Harvey Korman, you big dum-dum.
Oh, yeah, remember that's dum-dum? Right. Yes, yes.
The Great Gazoo.
I was going to say that, and I said, well, I don't know whether I'm going to be right or wrong, but I'll try it anyway.
Yeah, Tim Conway. Tom, well, here's a bonus question for you there to okay. make up for it.
Okay.
Harvey Korman was also on another show with Tim Conway, and Harvey Korman couldn't keep a straight face acting around Tim Conway in which vintage sketch comedy show?
Oh.
Do you remember Tim Conway and Harvey Korman on a show together?
Yeah, but I don't remember what show it was.
You know?
No idea.
He's always cracking up, and Tim Conway would just, like, dig right in and make him laugh even more.
No idea. Okay.
Doon, 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 doon. That's my Jeopardy stuff.
Oh!
All right, okay. But it was a Carol Burnett show.
Oh, okay.
Carol Burnett show.
Yes.
Okay.
I remember him being on that.
Yeah, it was funny. Yeah. It was great. Still stands up today.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Carol Burnett's probably still the funniest person.
Oh, yes. In the world. She was.
Here's a random one for you.
Okay.
Speaking of the classic theater play Waiting for Godot.
Okay.
Who would you cast, Steve, to play the perfect Pozo? Would you cast Dale Earnhardt or Dale Earnhardt Jr.?
Dale Earnhardt.
You're right. In the TV show Three's Company.
Yes.
Who was a salad chef that wanted to kill John Ritter's character Jack Tripper and, with parallels to the Scottish play, take over the restaurant? Was it A, Felipe, B, Eduardo, C, Enrique, or D, Bob?
Felipe.
Felipe, nice, you got it. Felipe. Yes. Okay, bonus point. Bonus point. Who played Felipe?
I have no idea.
Yeah. That's a tough one.
Yeah. Do you know?
Yeah.
Who?
Gino Conforti.
Who?
Gino Conforti.
Okay.
He's still around. He's still alive.
Oh, is he?
Yeah, he's like 89.
Wow.
I think he lives in Chicago.
Sheesh.
Oh, I know. Felipe.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. You're doing good, though.
Okay, thank you.
You got a couple wrong there, but you're still way ahead of the curve. Okay. So here's your final question.
Okay.
In Steve's very special Stone Pillow edition. Who is going to take the Stanley Cup in 2022? Now, is it A, the Vancouver Canucks, B, the Anaheim Ducks, C, the Winnipeg Jets, or D, the Las Vegas Knights?
Toss up. I would say Winnipeg.
Winnipeg Jets, of course. That's your team, right? Yes. That's your team. Yeah. Okay, well, who do you think they're going to beat in a sweep of that series for the Cup?
I would say probably Vancouver.
Yeah, you think Vancouver's going to play Jets for the Stanley Cup
in
2022?
Yeah.
All right, well, we're going to keep tabs on that and see. You know what, Steve? I think you win. I think you got the most answers right of all the stone pillows we've done this year, so congratulations
Thank you.
Thanks for playing.
No problem.
After my inability to sell all things Fringe to the Disney Corporation and make things better for everybody, I took some reflection. I got angry. I got sad. I went through all the stages of grief, but I brought balance back, and in reflection, I realized that Fringe Power needs a little bit more variety, some spice. And that's why I outreached my hand, and in doing so, I reached out to my good friend Steve to co-host Fringe Power with me for our final episode. Thank you very much again, Steve, for doing this. I think that was a lot of fun.
Oh, it was. It was absolutely a lot of fun, Tim. As I say, it's something I've never done before.
Would you do it again?
I would absolutely do it again.
Well, hopefully we get a chance to have you back on the show.
Thank you very much.
And we'll have real news for you to say next time.
Thanks.
Since the Fringe Festival is now officially over, this is what this episode is what we call the aftermath.
Okay.
Say aftermath with me.
Aftermath. Aftermath.
Again.
Aftermath.
Fringe Power.
Fringe Power.
That's exactly how it should. That's exactly how this episode should be starting. Is just like that. Thank you again, Steve.
Not a problem, Tim.
Steve, I had a great time with you on the show. I really appreciate you coming by. And
thank you very much. Yeah. I really enjoyed it.
No, good. And best wishes with the rest of your summer.
Thank you very much.
Go Jets.
Yes.
I want to thank all our Fundy Fringe guests this season. Special thanks to Stephen Coyle for being my co-host this episode. And thanks again to our musical guest, Jordan Alexander. Now, this genie gives 4 wishes. Thank you to you, the listener.
We leave you today with another song from Jordan Alexander.
This is Jordan Alexander and Radical T Productions. This is my time.
Tune in for more Fringe Power next year. See you in 2022.
I'm Tim.
I'm Steve.
And we're out.
Talking to me, I can see the light that is real when we hang together. So then I remember those good memories. He was in his room again, thinking about the old days. They never have to worry. Just take your time, I will be by your side tonight. She is so beautiful to this day. If I was dancing with her at my prom, the day I graduated in a few days, that we did so many good things. I jumped in the car with you. It's based on a true story that came all at once. I've been loving you so long. I will not disappoint you again, but you're not ready to do this on your own.